I want to play a game.
What do you get when you cross a mentally ill loner in a society?
No. Wrong movie. Not everything needs to be Joker.
Saw presents Spiral, a Star Wars story. I cannot wait to watch this movie. John and I said in a live stream a couple months ago that this is probably our most anticipated movie of the year. We are major, major fans of this franchise. In fact, we did a sketch a while ago called Greg Saw. I hope you guys can go check that out. There'll be a link in the description box. It really showcases our love for Saw. It's kind of a slow build, but when it gets going, it gets going. Anyway, enough talking. Let's watch this.
Begin.
What do you got there?
Oh, this is my wife, Emma. This is my son, Charlie.
You got a lot left.
Well, last.
Damn.
Nothing happier than the wife of a new detective.
Emma's cool, man. She's different. You know my wife.
You give a woman 600 Tuesdays. It ain't worth 3 Saturday nights.
How much money you got left? How many problems you got left? How many people you got left?
All available units, officer down.
Detective Banks and Rob.
This does feel different.
Yeah.
This does feel different.
But still like a type of cop movie.
Yeah. And starring.
This has another motive. They're targeting the cops.
Fascinating. Sam Jackson!
He's Jigsaw.
Yeah. Is that Billy? Yeah. Is that like a group of Jigsaw survivors?
You wanna play games, motherfucker?
Yeah.
Whoa! Oh man.
They got her to say it. From the Book of Saw. Right back to the first one. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. What's that? Oh. I guess you should subscribe and click that notification bell.
Does help.
I feel like this is an appropriate next step for the Saw franchise. It was interesting to me how this felt significantly more about not really the horror of body torture, but more about the investigative mystery behind it. And they didn't even show, like, you know, like Billy the Puppet or anything like that. So I wonder if that's even gonna appear in this movie. There was a slight image that I couldn't quite tell if that was a new puppet or if that was a new victim who was looked
it
like
looked
it was
like
at the train station.
With a top hat or something like that.
Yeah, and I get the impression that Sam Jackson's character is Danny Glover's brother. No, I get the impression that Sam Jackson's character has some type of specific history linked to the Jigsaw cases in some degree. There's something about the way his performance is coming across that just seems significantly more personal. You know, yeah. I'm not sure what it is, but that's the vibe I'm picking up on. Chris Rock, I feel like he'll be believable. Sure, why not? There's a part of me that was like, will I believe him in this? I'm not entirely sure, but I feel like I will. I mean, I've seen him do dramatic work like that. What was that Renee Zellweger one? Nurse Betty or
Nurse
something?
Nurse Betty, yeah. I
thought he was great in that movie, and like the opening of this just made me think Chris Rock's partner's wife and child are probably going to be in danger at some point. And
anytime you whip out a picture of your loved ones, it just doesn't bode well for anyone.
And you put focus on that.
Especially if cops are being targeted for this. You know?
And I like Chris Rock talking about marriage. It wasn't like stand-up comedy, but I'm like, I've heard Chris Rock talk a lot about this in stand-up comedy.
Yeah, yeah.
These kind of jokes that he was making. Chris Rock co-wrote this. There's like two other writers on board, but they got returning director Darren Lynn Bousman, who is a wonderful director who we've met a couple of times at events, specifically for this movie, hence the shirts. It doesn't feel like the other Saw movies that he directed. Like, there's some lighting choices that seem reminiscent of it.
It's not all green.
It's not all green. It's not all gray.
It's not all like, at least this trailer didn't have any of those ghost trail superimposed freak out montages. Like, everything looked very steady and very deliberate.
Yeah, it seems like there's there's a bit more of a budget to this one. I mean, the fact that you got Chris Rock and Sam Jackson here, you probably got a little bit more of a budget.
Yeah. Sam Jackson alone, I'm sure, can garner at least a bit of money for that movie beyond his rate.
It doesn't have as much of a grimy look, which is what I thought we might get considering we have Darren Lynn Bousman returning for this. I think it's pretty cool that you can get a director who helms so many of the, like, he did 2 through 4, but he's doing something different visually with this one, which I appreciate. I love that they got Sam Jackson to say that line.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Well, that's the thing, is like, this is perfect. Saw is exploitation enough that you can get away with that in a way that doesn't feel like it's too much, you know?
Especially when you have Sam Jackson there, which seems to
have to.
A bit of a self-awareness, because this is a very serious trailer for the most part. It's like Chris Rock is in it. I don't think it's going to be a comedy by any stretch, but I gotta imagine there'll be
personality.
I gotta imagine there's humor involved in the movie, you know?
Yeah, totally. Yeah. And there'll be, yeah, and there'll probably, because we've had, you know, 7 Saw movies up until this point, 8 now with 8. Jigsaw.
Yeah.
I'm sure it'll have some very knowing, very self-aware touches. I don't know exactly how it's gonna tie into Saw and what it's gonna do to convolute the bigger mythology. I did like that this felt like its own kind of side universe, and it did go back to the fact that every Saw movie is kind of a cop movie too, and it seems to be leaning more heavily into the cop side, kind of like the first one was, because the first Saw is nowhere near as gory as you remember it being. Like, there aren't as many crazy traps playing out. I mean, there are a lot that are showcased, but a lot of it's about Danny Glover and his partner, whose name I don't remember from Rush Hour.
Just Rush Hour.
Are, you know, doing the investigation and everything. And so I thought it was a smart way to go back to the roots in a sense, and go to the cop side and not so much the trap side, and then tease the trap side. Yeah. And now you got us wondering, what is Jigsaw, or whoever this is, whoever's doing the spirals, what is their thing gonna be? What are their traps gonna be like? Are there gonna be traps? It certainly looks like it from that last guy there.
Well, I don't imagine Tobin Bell will actually return in this one. And I'm hoping they don't bring him back. I feel like a lot of what has kind of held down the franchise a little bit, I mean, there's a variety of reasons, but I think one of them is they feel this need that they have to bring back Tobin Bell in some capacity. Yeah, yeah. I was actually a fan of the last, was the Spirit Brothers that did that one?
Yeah. Yeah,
and I like Jigsaw. I like the usage of Tobin Bell in it. It's just there are times where it does feel a little bit forced, and I don't think it's necessary. And I think to move on to something new, you gotta leave him behind, you know?
Yeah. Tobin Bell is like one of the best parts of literally every Saw movie, except he only belongs in maybe like half of them. I would be fine with that, not having Tobin Bell in this one, because I am like as much of a Saw fan as I am, and as much as I appreciate, for better or for worse, them really pursuing one storyline for so many movies, I am very much ready for the series, the idea to evolve, to just try on a different flavor, and I hope that, you know, it seemed like Chris Rock was really jazzed about whatever idea he had.
Well, I don't think this is a time jump. I imagine that we're going to be seeing some of how the city or the world has been affected by the countless Jigsaws there have been. Yeah. Are they going to wrap up the cliffhanger with Jigsaw, specifically the last Saw movie?
I hope they don't have to.
Because there was a cliffhanger there, and it would be kind of bummer and annoying if it was like, oh, the killer is just the guy from the last movie. Because it seems like they want to do something completely different here. I get the vibe that they'll probably heavily acknowledge the first 7, but they might ignore the 8th one. Just the impression that I'm getting. But I also think we're going to be dealing with the repercussions of, you know, maybe some of the victims who have survived some of these traps, like when they're going into the church at one point. Riffing off what you're saying, it does seem like they're going much more back to the first one. You know, it's about a cop and his partner. You don't see a lot of gore here, at least in the trailer. I imagine there will be in the movie, but it does seem to be a lot more investigative. There's that moment where they're wearing masks, that maybe they're going undercover. For some type of mission to take this guy down. It feels more like a thriller than a horror movie. Yeah.
And there seems, at least as of this trailer, they're keeping the horror elements pretty close to the vest, Alfred.
Yeah. All right, Reject Nation, what did you think of this trailer for Spiral? Comment below.
I want to play a game.
By having you click that notification bell and subscribing, hitting the like button. And hey, you know what? Let's shout out some patrons right now. These patrons are playing pledge for the Diluted Takes and BTS tier, who get access to our exclusive Len story, but also we shout them out now as part of the reward tier. Thank you guys so much for your support. Let's name them off one at a time in Jigsaw voice.
Gregory Bullock, Ruby, Javier Gomez, Luke Anderson, Philip J. Smith, Junior, Jen Smith, Rosa, Para, Bailey Reichert, Erica, Tuesday, Josh, James, Nobrika. For months you have been pledged to our Patreon page. And now this is your punishment to see if you really want to stick around.